1,000 injuries, so Fortunato I had borne as I best could. But when he ventured upon insult, I vowed revenge. You, who so well know the nature of my soul, will not suppose, however, that gave utterance to a threat. At length, I would be avenged. This was a point definitely settled. But the very definitiveness with which it was resolved precluded the idea of a risk.
I must not only punish, but punish with impunity. A wrong is unredressed when retribution overtakes its redresser. It is equally unredressed when the avenger fails to make himself felt as such to him who has done the wrong. Fortunato had a weak point, although in other regards he was a man to be respected and even feared. He prided himself on his connoisseurship in wine. Few Italians have the true virtuoso spirit. In painting and gemmery, Fortunato, like his countrymen, was a quack. But in the matter of old wines, he was sincere. In this respect, I did not differ from him materially.
My dear Fortunato, you are luckily met. How well you are looking today. I have received a pipe of what passes for Amontillado, and I have my doubts.
How? Amontillado? A pipe? Impossible. And in the middle of the carnival?
I have my doubts, and I was silly enough to pay the full Amontillado price without consulting you in the matter. You were not to be found, and I was fearful of losing a bargain.
Amontillado?
As you're engaged, I'm on my way to Lucrezia. If anyone has a critical turn, it is he. He will
Lucrezia
tell me...
Lucrezia cannot Amontillado from Charay.
And yet, some fools will have it that his taste is a match for your own.
Come, let us go.
Where?
To your vaults.
My friend, no, I will not impose upon your good nature. I perceive you have an engagement.
I have no engagement. Come.
My friend, no. It's not the engagement. The severe cold with which I perceive you are afflicted. The vaults are insufferably damp. They are encrusted with nitre.
Let us go. Nevertheless, the cold is merely nothing. Amontillado, you have been imposed upon, and for Lucchesi, he cannot distinguish Sherry from Amontillado.
There were no attendants at home. They had absconded to make merry in honor of the time. I had told them that I should not return until the morning, and I had given them explicit orders not to steer from the house. These orders were sufficient. I well knew to ensure their immediate disappearance, one and all, as soon as my back was turned. The gait of my friend was unsteady, and the bells upon his cap jingled as he strode.
It is farther on, but observe the white webwork which gleams from these cavern walls.
Nitre,
how long have you had that cough?
It's nothing.
Come, we will go back.
Enough. The cough is mere nothing.
Your health is precious. You are happy, as once I was. You are a man to be missed. We will go back. You are ill, and I cannot be responsible. Besides, there's Lucrezia.
It will not kill me. I shall not die of a cough.
True, true.
I had no intention of alarming you, but perhaps a draught of this Medoc He'll defend us from the damps. Drink.
I drink to the bird that reposes around us.
And I to a long life.
These vaults are extensive.
The Montresors were a great family.
And the motto.
Nemo me impune lacessit. The nitre, it increases.
It's nothing. Let us go on. But first, draught of this Madoc. Are you part of the Mason?
Yes.
A sign.
We pass through long walls of pad skeletons with casks and puncheons intermingling. Into the inmost recesses of the catacombs, we continued our route in search for the Amontillado. The crypt becomes less and less spacious.
Proceed. Herein is the Amontillado. Pass your hand over the wall. You cannot help feeling the nitre. Indeed, it is very damp. Once more, let me implore you to return. No? Then I must positively leave you. But I must first render you all the little attentions in my power.
A very good joke indeed. We'll have many rich laugh about it. Over our wine.
True. The Amontillado.
Yes, the Amontillado. But is it not getting late? Will not they be awaiting us? The Lady Fortunato. For the love of God, Montresor!
Yes, for the love of God!
Fortunato. My heart grew sick. It was the dampness of the catacombs that made it so. I hastened to make an end of my labor. I forced the last stone into its position. I plastered it up. Against the new masonry, I re-erected the old rampart of bones. For the half of a century, no mortal has disturbed them. In pace requiescat.